What makes a ball curve in mid-air? Like this? Or like this? Let's find out! So how did the ball curve mid-air? According to Newton's first law of motion, a moving object will continue to move in a straight line unless acted upon by an external force. What force was acting on the ball? The secret lies in the spin. When you hit the ball at an angle with a brushing action, friction from the rubber surface spins the ball. As the ball travels, air flows from the front of the ball to the back. On one side, the ball is spinning in the same direction as the airflow. On the other side, the ball is spinning in the opposite direction as the airflow. Friction between the air and the ball surface makes the air on one side of the ball to flow faster and gets deflected to the other side. But on the other side, air is slowed down and isn't deflected. Due to Newton's third law, the deflected air exerts an equal and opposite force on the ball. This pushes the ball perpendicular to its original direction of travel. So the ball curves. This is called the Magnus Effect. It is not limited to side spin. It can also be seen in backspin, which counteracts gravity and makes the ball travel further, as well as topspin, which makes the ball dive down to the ground earlier. The Magnus Effect was first described by Sir Isaac Newton in 1672. He discovered this when he was playing tennis with his friend in Cambridge. In addition to table tennis and tennis, the Magnus Effect can also be seen in football and baseball. But I think it is best seen in table tennis because of the light ball and friction of modern rubber. Did you know that professional table tennis players can make the ball spin up to 9,000 rotations per minute? That is 18 times faster than a helicopter rotor. So the next time you play table tennis, don't forget to apply spin and use the Magnus Effect to confuse your opponent.